I'm Arthur Boyle of Performance Appraisal Services. We're residential real estate appraisers with a company founded in 1994 by Mike Gianelli and I in the basement of my house in Malden. We've since grown to have offices in Malden and Pembroke. We serve the eastern Mass counties, including Cape Cod. A good client for us is an attorney or a private landowner or a private property owner who's going through a probate process or a divorce division of property. Call us at 781-293-6900. Ask for Arthur Boyle or Amanda Boyle Grazioso. Our first name is Performance.
Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through an audio recording, which will be used to ensure an accurate record of the proceedings produced in the minutes of the meeting. All comments made in open session will be recorded. I guess first up, we're going to be discussing some future development options for parcel at 6280 Oak Street. Gentlemen, how are you?
Hi, good evening. I'm Brian Murphy. I represent the ownership at Corporate Park and 260 280 Oak. I guess there are a couple of things that I wanted to discuss today. The first one is the cease and desist that I have on 260 and 280 due to the clearing, just talk about that for a minute with the board. And then the other one is just, we're about to submit for that 6-acre parcel. The back part of it, hopefully, we're hoping to do somewhat of a phased approach to it. And I just wanted to informally show you what we're thinking. We should be submitting something formally in the next week or so. Okay. So I guess the first item I just wanted to talk about, and it's become a little bit nebulous as far as what's going on, we had cleared that acreage, and I think when I come in last year, came in a few times, we talked about clearing some of the acreage up there and also on the other side for marketing purposes. Regardless of whether we were in agreement or whatnot, it turns out that there is a town bylaw, not a zoning bylaw, not a planning rules and regulations bylaw, but section 19 or miscellaneous section in the back of the town bylaw, number 19, I think it is, that says you can't clear trees on your property without a full planning board approved permit. Now, it kind of puts us in a little bit of a pickle because there really is not a clear way to resolve the issue, you know, once it's done. I think I got a letter as of the end of November, it was up to $12,500 worth of fines.
We actually got copied on that letter and I was a little confused in 15 days how it had, if it's $100 a day, how did it get to 12,000 in 15 days?
Yeah. So I'm not sure exactly how that is. Each parcel, I guess. I don't know what the stomach is for you know, enforcement of it or whatnot. But one of the things that I talked to George very about, who's, you know, George is just trying to, I guess, he's been told to, you know, make sure that this is front and center. So I've been working with him on it.
Yeah.
And he said what we talked about was, because he knows there's really not a great way to resolve the issue, you know, he said, you know, it might help to have some sort of support from the planning board, or that we, you know, we had discussed it and it was a item that we were interested in.
I did send the letters, you know, kind of pointing out, and after Becky and I had talked, that we thought it was kind of arbitrary, where there were a couple other spots up there that had the similar things that happened, and
right.
I don't believe they were being fined, but The only thing I can think of to kind of resolve it, this is just my own personal opinion, is to try to get this moving as fast as we can.
Right.
I don't see any other way unless they.
Right. And I guess that's the direction we're pointed, and we're going to go that way.
Yeah.
And I don't know, at some point, you know, somebody might say, hey, you know, there's, you know, fine for, well, geez, what could it be up to now? I mean, I don't know, but that's certainly going to put brakes on the development, or something I think that we've all talked about really wanting to move forward.
You were pretty far along in the site plan though for that, weren't you?
Well, I had a conceptual plan that we presented, so that we had kind of communicating a need for greater coverages and things like
right.
that
and,
to change
and,
the bylaw.
And you had gone to the ZBA and gotten some relief from some existing
Correct.
Bylaws, and
Correct.
Then we had actually changed them.
Correct.
And you were in kind of a hurry to get the approval through ZBA, even though we were on track to provide relief through the bylaw change. So,
right.
What slowed things down for you?
You know, it's funny, just the I guess a confluence of issues. Number one, just getting meetings together and people in the same room to make decisions. We went to three or four meetings where they just didn't have quorum. And we actually ended up with constructive approval of what we were looking for through ZBA. And it wasn't a big deal because we were all kind of in agreement anyway, so. But it did. It went 100 days before we got to it. And I'm presuming the Attorney General's already approved.
That was the next question I was going to have.
Yeah. I'm presuming the Attorney General has approved the coverages and whatnot of the bylaw change that happened with the town meeting.
Yeah, we would have been notified of that in November.
You were?
We would have been. So
would've
if
been.
It was a problem, you would have.
Oh, okay. Got it.
So
yeah, I don't know.
I don't think there was, but you probably should talk to the selectman secretary
and
get confirmation.
Yeah. But either way, I guess we have ZBA approval for what we were looking to do as far as coverages. We have the ability to go forward. So what we are proposing to do is kind of work our way from the back of that site to the front. The first being two buildings. You just, if you don't mind, I'll orientate you to the site again. This is Oak Street, the bend on Oak Street. This is obviously the buildings that are up right now. And this is the top of the boot. So what we're proposing is to build two buildings in the back here. And get this site ready and presentable for development in phase two. So we're looking just to kind of get this.
The access is
the
end
of
the building.
Yeah.
Up there.
Okay, yeah.
So we come right into
okay,
right. So I'm just looking at is some type of improvement so we can get. Because you could, you're gonna have vehicles going both sides of this to gain
it's,
to get
it,
that.
I call it narrow throated
right.
right now,
right.
And I think though because of the separation of buildings, you have an amount available that could improve slightly. Shall
right.
we
and
say?
That's what I'm getting at. Because you have sight
full
lines,
access.
You have sight line issues as to traffic coming coming out of here and coming around that building all of a sudden. You know what I mean? You may have
coming around this building
yeah.
here?
You,
yeah.
When you're proposing these buildings here, and I understand you guys are back to back here like this.
Yeah.
Is there access on the back of this building?
Currently, your access is very limited.
They're not loading docks, are they?
No. There's a couple of drive-in garage doors.
All right, so we got to kind of wrap this
yeah,
up.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm going to take
oh, no, that's all right. That's all
right.
So I guess the next step is you guys to draw it up and bring it back?
Yeah, we'll submit a full plan with drainage and whatnot. I didn't cover everything, but I just wanted to give an overview, and we'll be back in a few weeks.
Good. Excellent. Good.
great. Thank you all.
All right, thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.
All right, so we have the folks here for 345 Oak Street.
So Brian, this is for you. We got a bunch of these.
Anybody 345 Oak Street?
Yeah, they're right.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
Steve, your calendar.
Brian, your 40 puzzle.
So what do you think, everybody?
That is it.
Oh, Chris, I'm Sudi from Waymouth. Alexis Bill, I've built a couple of houses in town here.
Sorry.
Good luck. So I'm proposing, and this is very, not quite as good, but just a question. 345 Oak Street, which is right behind the Dunkin' Donuts. You come off the express bridge, come left onto Oak Street. Mm-hmm. You have Dunkin' Donuts. You have that link, that lot with the small yellow house on it, and then Tomasi's.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess that piece of property is where Tomasi's owns is the yellow bungalow house there. For a couple of years, at least since 1966, nothing's been done there, but proposing, at least under agreement with them, is to purchase that, but it's a non-conforming lot in several areas. So, as my understanding, and talking to quite a few people here, it's non-conforming for several reasons. First, it's frontage is there. For a commercial lot, we need at least 2 acres, my understanding. Falls short with that, with 1.7 acres. It may also fall short with being conforming, as it only has 185 feet of frontage, where it possibly needs 200. And the fact also that we really don't have any zoning, and listening to the board prior to me, that these tradesmen's units don't particularly have any type of designation with the town to for their filings for what they fall under. So these tradesmen units, I've been told, they're not sure what they want to classify because they're not sure what's in them. By trade, whatever they decide.
That was me, perhaps. I'm not
perhaps,
sure.
Yeah.
So this may reflect my limited knowledge, or okay. I'm not sure.
But talking to several people, it seems to be the general consensus that the opinion has to come from this board, at least the planning board. So with that said, just getting on board for this meeting, I was not able to put together something that's a little bit more formal, but at least this way I show you. I was proposing for this area to put up 10 trade units that basically fit on the footprint in the designated area, but does, unfortunately, some of the parking areas goes into the setbacks of the area, which is something that you guys would have to consider or at least look at. ZBA, when I talked to them, she says that it isn't really under her jurisdiction, and again, coming back to you guys, so everything seemed to keep coming back to you as to whether or not something like this would be accepted. That lot hasn't had anything done with it. I don't know what can be done with it because it does fall under the building, under building B. And the board would have to make a decision to see if it's something they'd like to consider.
It is a lot that seems like it's hard to develop without sort of giving something in terms of making some allowances or with the setbacks or some. Otherwise, it may sort of remain undeveloped for a long time, or at least hard to develop.
That proposal is going to be built by myself. I will be an owner-occupied. My son and I, we have a small environmental company. We do plan on being on the property and not just using it as investment property, but we'll also be there every day also.
So why not that number of units?
Why that number of units? That number fits on there from a standpoint, from a loan value, from my designation with my financing. This is a ratio that comes back with a payment within what I want to pay back for, so for a income from the property. The fire department, I've spent quite a bit of time with them because I understand that I wanted to make sure that everything was safe with them. They have no problem with two buildings. They'll come out at 6,000 square feet each, which doesn't require sprinkling. As I was going to try and use the well, there's an artesian well on the property, I was going to try and use that well, whereas I'm only going to have basically a toilet and a hand sink in the unit, so it'll be minimal water usage at all. As long as we keep it under 6,000, it doesn't need to be sprinkled, and the chief said as long as the buildings are of this configuration and size, and I did put the fire road around the back of the building, so there'll be access basically coming in around the back of the building for the fire department. initially I was told it was 20, now I was told it's possibly 18. With the planning board can differentiate that if they feel the need. It can go down to 16 if I had to. The septic will fit up on the top here. If it doesn't, I can have the septic design so that the road can go over it.
Right now there's only one entrance to that property?
No, there's two, sir.
There is now.
Yeah, there's an island here with two entrances there. I tried to conform it so that at least when you came in, you basically could make the loop around there for both police and fire. And using that setback to keep that, just the sign, keeping the vegetation, everything that we're going to require to be on a lot.
What are the square footage for each unit, I guess?
So the units are going to be 50 feet by 25 by 22 feet tall, 20-foot doors in the front of them with a walking passage door to the side of each unit.
So it's about 450 square feet, roughly?
So each bay is, did you say 6,000 square feet?
6,000 for the entire building.
I'm sorry. So each one would be about
1,000.
Six thousand, looks like ten units.
Two different buildings, two separate buildings.
Each 6,000.
Yeah. Each building, correct.
So 12,000 divided by 10.
Right? Yeah.
So each bay would be about 1,200 square feet.
Is a 22-foot height, is only each one the single story?
Single stories.
Double story.
Single stories.
Frankly, I think it's too much traffic onto the site. But you're right next to the Dunkin' Donuts. People take the lefts and rights out of there all day long. We're within a couple hundred feet of that set of lights, et cetera. We just had a proponent in here for a proposal that's going to bring in several car trips more per day past that site. You've got a site across the street from you that's also probably going to come up for reuse and purpose, currently being used as a basketball court and a tennis court. I don't think that's the long-term use of that building and site. You're really squeezing us.
As far as units or the space itself?
Traffic.
Well, designating two parking spaces per unit, Tradesman units as I do, like I know we come and go. We're there in the morning for a short time, gone for the day, and then come back.
No trucks?
No trucks, just storage for our equipment for an environmental company.
So, I mean, but in 10 sites, could you, like 10
No
units?
Parking. There'll be no outside parking on the facility. Each space is designated two parking spaces with a dumpster pad. I initially put a dumpster pad in front of each one if they want a dumpster, but they're only allowed two spaces with no outside parking on the property.
Okay.
No outside industry, no.
So there'd be no storage of vehicles?
No storage of any type on the property. No automotive, no painting, nothing that's going to be environmentally concerned as far as the neighborhood.
So just let me ask go a little further then. That two parking spaces per unit, no other traffic onto the site?
No. No retailers.
It's hard for me to wrap my mind around that one. How do we determine that? We don't know what uses potentially can go in here, only that there's 10 of them. We have no idea as to potentially what they could be.
We're not leaning towards the retail or more so sort of storage. So can I
answer
that? No, I can't.
Retail, or are you going to say to us we would exclude retail?
I would exclude retail since this is a workman's trade unit just for professionals. Plumbers, electricians, myself, like an environmental company. People are going to be using this basically for storage, not for coming and going. And
mm-hmm. Well, I think perhaps, I don't know, if you could devise a plan. I wouldn't be opposed to it. I would just ask you to be considerate of the idea that we have a lot of other potential traffic coming through that area. You're familiar with the area.
I am, sir.
Yeah. So you know that the traffic considerations on 139 are a challenge right now for us to deal with. And you know, we have a 40B or something in our packet tonight on Water Street, which is very close to that. You've probably seen new development on the corner of Water and Cross Street, which is a assisted living facility, if you will. So, and then we have a big retailer who wants to expand what he's trying to do with the Stop and Shop Plaza and other sites. We have a lot of potential traffic. I just want to bring you up to date on that. And we have to be considerate of that. with whatever we approve on this in that area right now. So maybe you devise something. I'd encourage you to do so.
Just a quick point on that. Is a variance required if it is less than 2 acres?
Well, yeah, there would be a variance requirement.
A variance,
anything that's in
well,
the
frontage,
and then there's some setback issues here. I'm not sure more concerning because I don't think we would encourage a variance on the setbacks.
No,
even for parking.
Yeah.
So right here I have basically the Commonwealth of Mass owns a section there, and the drive-through is over here from Dunkin' Donuts. Yeah. Expressway in the back, obviously front, and then to the other side is Tomasi's area, which is
open.
All open. These setbacks don't have to be, well, they will be. I'm not going to say that they're not going to be, and this is not to scale. Part of the reason being is because I'm here to see if you guys, or the board, is at least considerate of the fact before I were to spend time with grading to draw everything to scale. But yes, I'm not going to say that these aren't going to be touching upon some of the areas of setback.
Sure. It's a tough spot.
It is, and that's
why
it is tight. I mean, I could do 8 units, but I'm shrinking the building. Basically, the building falls within the parameters of where it has to be without being in the setbacks. But yes, I am going to be kind of encroaching on a little bit of the areas. Can I take away?
What about coverage and
there's a reason, as you reminded us, that the site hasn't been developed or redeveloped since 1966.
Yes, sir.
That's not because it isn't valuable or it doesn't represent something very potentially worthwhile to a business. It's the problem of what the site consists of that's created the 50-year gap of new development. Maybe you can work with the Tomasi's. They have come here before, the Tomasi group. You know, what can we do on this site? I don't know. You tell us. We're not here as your design team.
Well,
but,
I guess the board, you know, I guess that's why I am here, to maybe push that envelope. Nobody's taking the chance. I understand that some are inquiring. I'm not opposed to any suggestions the board might have to. I mean, I'm not sure how else we could configure that. I configured it this way just for that reason, with the two buildings and the driveways and the access. I don't expect a lot of traffic in these units. I understand Oak Street has a lot of traffic on it. I understand there's other developers, but other developers, that would put me in the same category. So
right. We couldn't discriminate against you on that.
No, I didn't. That was not a reflection.
And I'm not trying to use it as a reason for denial. I'm just trying to indicate to you that we have to take into consideration those factors.
Yes, sir.
And it's important that what you propose, if that, you know, it kind of meets some concerns of ours, at least in terms of the traffic in and off site, and how it affects the general area you're in.
You're going to take into consideration water runoff. What are you going to do with that?
Great.
Stormwater. There's a lot of things that, you know, that look good on paper, but may not meet any regs and rules.
It was about a year ago that the lady came in with a trying to do a daycare there.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. But you can just go up to the Petco or the pet place up the street, had to put in drainage and retention, and you know, and what do they got? They got a building on a lot with some parking. What you've got is you've got a building on a lot with a lot of driveway that may not, first off, to meet the, just to get close to being, to meet any, some of the regs, you may not have that parking, the road in the backside, all right? There may have to be all grass. There may have to be, you know, you may have two dead ends going in there to meet some, to get close because of the way that site's set up. But so that has to be looked at from an engineering standpoint.
Grady was going to prepare this, but he was actually being considerate of me saying, Mike, I'd like you to go see where the board's feeling is, where the consensus is. Right. I can do this to that. There's not as much as we thought with the runoff and everything. When he looked at it, he said the same thing. But he said, it's not, the area doesn't, it warrants what we want to do with that, and being able to do it, I think I can, but again, we're here discussing the issues of traffic and whether or not you think it's acceptable or it's something you want to see. That's always something the board can decide.
I guess that impacts a bit.
Well, I guess, you know, I guess draw it up really.
We have to see a little bit more.
Yeah, I'm not opposed to spending the revenues to drop this up. I'd just like to see if the board is willing. I understand it's a give and take, and it's a little bit of uncharted territory with this piece. Whether or not the board will at least...
It's uncharted territory.
Well, as far as it seems like in the last 2 days of being here, I've heard quite a few different, these trading units, and I'm not sure exactly where those still fall under the planning board, where...
Yeah, that's something I was going to mention.
Think of it as a storage unit.
We need to know that.
Yeah. If that's what we want to call it.
I mean, is it or is it not allowable under the...
You can think of it as a storage unit, because what you're saying is people are going to come there, they're going to drop their stuff, they're going to pick up stuff, and they're leaving.
Okay.
That's what people do in a storage unit. That's one way to look at it. It's not like there's going to be, what you're saying is there's not a lot of activity there.
Correct.
Power. My question is that has the fire department, what's the structure made of, wood?
Tin. It should be made of metal building.
Okay. And you got a letter from them stating that they're not going to require sprinklers.
Correct.
Well, because of the square footage.
Correct. I've been with them 3 days now. I've met with the chief and the captain three times. I'm speaking for them, but not as the final word. But yes, they're in agreement with what they've seen and said, Mike, we're good with that as long as the board is willing to entertain it. So I said, okay.
Okay. All right. Because, I would just, for your own benefit, I would get it in writing that.
And maybe you've already talked about this with the fire department too, but talking about square footage and requirements for having the building sprinklered, because of the access issues that you have with the fire road and some of the setback issues, you may want to consider having the building sprinklered, because that may provide you a little bit more leeway on some of those other issues that you worked out with them to get access.
He didn't even say he wanted this. All he wanted to be able to do is make sure he could get a truck up here, and I left him at least 3 feet between the buildings so he could do an inspection by walking around if it's so be. So basically, utilities when it comes through the middle here. I said, how far apart would you like it? Does the planning board have some sort of desert? He said, it's up to us. As long as you give me a space that I can walk through and I can get around. I don't even care if I can drive around the building, but we ended up giving it to him because the septic can go underneath it.
Yeah, what I'm saying is you may not even need that access if you had it sprinkled. You may, I don't know.
If I didn't put the road there, the buildings are still pretty much set. I could maybe put parking here, but unfortunately, the parking on the sides is where I.
Yeah, but I'm also thinking about the ratio of impervious.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yep.
Where you may need a little bit more, green in there.
Exactly.
And if you had the building sprinkler, that may allow you to do that.
Understood.
Right.
Yeah.
Because that takes out the. That takes out the idea of using the wall.
Yeah.
All right, so I guess.
It does seem like we need sort of clarity on the issue of the zoning, like whether it's an allowed use in the zoning, because, I mean, we've got this one, we've got Brian Murphy talking about this very similar thing, it seems as though.
Is there a conflict there, Matthew? Is there a conflict there?
And conflict in what?
Is there a question as to whether the use is allowed?
Yeah, I mean, is it actually an allowed use? Is it actually an allowed use in this zone?
Or for that matter, industrial area that goes over to Winter Street? I believe all of those in there are some form of industrial condominium or leased space. What's proposed from Murphy's side? It has essentially the same thing. He's got a various amount of uses
This is business district B, correct?
I think they're identical in each case.
Yeah. The use should be fine.
Yeah. There's not a question of use. I don't see that as the issue here at all. What I do see is a big problem with all the things we brought up to you. I can only say for myself, we've beaten this pretty well. Is that you're going to have to at least prove to me how that works.
Okay.
And you're going to have to draw a plan. And that's going to have to come at your expense if you want to get a second go around. Sorry to say.
And then he's going to have to seek some variances on the things that are, we can't do anything about.
We don't even know until we really see it.
Maybe before you seek variances, you might want to see what you...
Now, did you say you're buying this from Tomasi?
Correct.
I mean, on the frontage, why can't Tomasi sell you another 20 feet?
It's an option.
It's an option. Now, you know what I'm saying?
Well, that would make things a lot easier.
And that's on the tail end of the...
Take out the variances, increase your lot size, and you're going to have a better shot.
Yeah, take care of two issues with one.
Right, because that's on the end of the storage area, so...
The only thing he's keeping in there is old fir trees.
Is winter storage of trees.
Yeah. Make it to the spring.
Is Rick Grady your engineer?
Yes, he is.
Have a discussion with Rick. He's pretty savvy.
He is savvy to the design, but again, it was the whether the board would at least entertain the variances.
Okay, so it's not so much that we entertain the variances.
We don't do variances.
Variance is ZBA. But one of the things we'll be concerned about is lot coverage for the building and the impervious area. Rick knows that.
Yes, sir.
So he's got to look at that to see what he can do. You're going to have to look at your drainage. It's probably going to have to be underground contained.
Yes, correct. It is.
This is going to be...
I don't want to speak for him because...
No, I don't either.
That's why I'm holding back on what I know he can do, but...
Okay.
Thank you.
So we'll see you back.
All right. Okay.
So...
All right, so next up is, we're going to keep moving, 19A.
Yeah, Dan Smith had a quick thing with his form. I don't know if you want him to... I think it'll only take like a minute or two if you want him to jump in front, if you want him, or if you want to stay with the order.
Is the folks from 19A here?
Yeah, we're
behind, so we'll take them first.
So you're Nicole?
Yes. Okay. Yep, Nicole is evening.
How are you?
And this is Mike.
How's it going, Jamie?
So the property that we are talking about, so I'm a buyer's agent, so I'm on the real estate side, but representing a potential buyer for the property 19A, Mattakeesett. So just to kind of place where that's at, that's between the garage of the funeral home, across from the Stop and Shop, and then between the bank on the other side.
Yeah, you're talking about the two buildings?
The two buildings. So it's the second one, the further one in. They're actually both up
the
hill.
The one in the back?
Yes. Yep. Yeah, so we have bordering that the land behind the bank, the land behind the funeral home, and then the cemetery. So what we're talking about is not, like, the building right now is vacant. So that we were open to what potential tenant uses it would be, but what interest there is in changing and clearing a little bit of the back to be a yard for landscaping. So to have a small landscaping irrigation business, there is a larger excavation. So that's really on a larger scale right on the other side of that property. Yeah. Yes. And then there is a landscaping company around the corner, but this is just a smaller, again, his side is more the irrigation. There's also a small component of landscaping. So it's already a paved component behind the building, which would store vehicles, and it's hidden behind the building, and we're talking about the secondary building. And so why we're of concern too is it's called that center protection zone, and which is that front part of it. But again, I think that this is a good site. We've looked at a lot of different potential sites, and there's not anybody really.
There's already an approved site.
Right
on 53.
There's already an approved site?
Yes. But they're not looking at that.
That's already up for, it's up for sale. It's
for sale. I might have
just
to look at it.
It's up for sale. It's been in here for a design and approval.
Oh, really?
And that is not going to be a good site.
No.
Okay.
No. So I'm being upfront because of traffic. Nice. Trucks coming in and out of the center. It is a tough spot. I would be against it. Okay. I'll be honest with you right now before we go too far. But on 53, there's a site that's already approved.
Right in the landscaping yard.
Right.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I'd love to look at it. Yeah, I mean, the big thing is, you know, I'm not, my father and I own, he owns a small landscape company, I own an irrigation company. Right. Just really looking for storage for equipment. I'm not looking to sell material or anything like that, or have trucks in and out. Right. We leave in the morning, we're back at night. That's
not
pretty much
customers.
It.
It's
yeah.
Just
you know, there's a guy. As they say, go. There's a guy building storage.
There's
anyway.
Two properties.
There's
a
professional office use.
Yeah, and there's two separate parcels.
Yeah.
Well, it's
common driveways.
Right now,
though.
Common
two
driveways.
Yeah. Two driveways is kind of considered though. So this is actually a 1.22 acre usage of that. And then the front portion was 0.66.
Mm-hmm.
So it is, again, it's just that it was that back portion. The traffic is very limited because there's no customers, so it's probably less than there was as a dental facility. It's just that there's some vehicles that are probably there in the morning and then at the end of the day. So it actually doesn't necessarily have to conflict as much with the surrounding uses as the bank opens later, as the funeral home's actually located a little bit further, and that's the parking lot, and that's the garage side of that. And then you have the cemetery abutting it in the back. So that's why if there was going to be a spot, it seems to actually be a good one for their size company, and then without having to really modify the use of the building, but also take a portion of it, which could, I mean, it's up
so that so then so let me go further.
Sure.
All right, so you only need a portion of it, so I'm assuming you're going to subdivide that building.
I wouldn't necessarily subdivide.
But you may rent.
Yeah, potentially. Yeah, okay. Depending on on what's allowed.
Right, because it's a big building.
Right. Yeah, we took a look at it today, and the bottom space needs complete renovation.
The whole thing kind of does. So it's 4,000 square feet. So that's the other thing, is if this was an allowable use in the back, open to what the board wants to see there as a tenant.
We wouldn't do any kind of retail or anything like that, even for the rental.
It's office.
Maybe office space. I've been looking for something in this price range, and that's why
and
we wanted
building.
To present it.
Yeah.
I wasn't familiar with the spot on 53. I don't know if maybe I haven't seen it because it's out of my price range or what. But
I'm just saying this. I know I came in here. There was someone proposing a landscape company with storage, and we had somebody come in and look at that site for storage units.
Yeah.
But I do know it's up for sale. I'm just It's on a main road.
It's right opposite Crystal Pool. Crystal Pool?
Yeah.
No, Cherry Hill.
Cherry Hill. I'm sorry. Anyway. So,
okay. And but I do know they've already gone through, I think, the approval process.
Okay.
Yeah. That's a while ago.
Yeah. It's still. Well, I don't know now, but it's still.
I think that site plan was. God, it's got to be my first term, so it's.
So I don't think it's that old as old as you think it is. No,
a couple of years ago.
Yeah. Maybe 3 or 4 years at the max.
Came up with a new building design.
Was it approved and then never built?
It's got to be. Yeah. Well, you're on the board.
Yeah, I was on the board.
All right, so it could be 5 years ago.
Right. That's right.
If it's still on the market. I saw the acreage on it, and it was one of those things where. I've been looking for a long time somewhere to grow.
Well, the back portion of that is wetland.
Oh, it is, okay.
And there's a detention area on that. It backs up to the cemetery and the DPW commissioner of that.
Right.
No?
Yeah, it's on the bank property at the end, right?
Right, but it also is on I think it's, they're probably close.
Yeah, so the line actually pulls
wet.
Right there.
So where you playing the cemetery?
Listen, we have to go someplace. But my point is that the center is a very problematic, even though we're doing improvements on the roadway, still there's a lot of traffic that enters and goes through that center. There is restrictions on center protection.
Mm-hmm.
And, I don't know if I'd be with it, but I'm just one vote.
I don't want to be, I'm not trying to do anything that.
No, I understand that. You wouldn't be in here if you weren't trying to be up.
Right. I mean, the reason I like the site is because, like Nicole said, it's further back, it's behind another building. Mm-hmm. You can't really see the back from the street. It's got the space in the back for what I need to do, just for, truck and material storage. Nothing crazy like that. And we're not looking to do a retail, I'm not looking to sell. We are usually out in the morning, back later, usually around 7:30 we get back during the summers. And then if we go back, it's just to load up some material with maybe one or two trucks at the most. But that's really it. Once we're out, we take our stuff with us and then we don't come back till later. So that's kind of what I was thinking about as far as the traffic aspect of it.
And it does have the two driveways. It has a potential too, so it is that it does, it's kind of set up to have some traffic already. It was a traffic space, having professional offices, having a dental, so it did have an inflow and an outflow for the Wolf building. So this would actually limit it, because the set amount of traffic that you're going to have, there isn't the customers as much.
Trust me, there wasn't that much going on in the dentist shop. I used to go there. So there wasn't a lot of traffic coming out there for years. The question is how much traffic to come out in the future, not necessarily with your business, but with the businesses, somebody that you're going to put in there to offset your rent or lease. And then, so now you got multiple businesses working out of that site.
If it, honestly, if it came down to that, if it was easier to, you know,
if somebody buys it now, right, as is, and does offices in there,
it's no different. I mean, but it's an allowed use.
They need to come before us?
No, they could probably go in there.
Who knows? They're not changing the site,
though. Right.
And it's an allowed use.
Right.
But if it's a change of use, maybe technically.
Technically.
But in practice, they're probably.
That may be the issue.
Yeah, if it's offices. So this is a way to kind of say what's in there. And like Mike said, he's willing to not have a tenant if that was going to make or break it, or to give some say.
We know how things go in life. We can talk about not having it and being restrictions, but then who enforces that, who follows it, who monitors it. You know, it's just, that's just how things go. Things change.
I'd rather see a tenant in there than out of there.
Yeah.
Well, someone's going to own it. The question is, is there going to be someone who buys it for a different rate?
And you're planning on improving the existing building?
It's in shambles.
I'm one person, but I wouldn't be adverse to it.
Well, I'd like to see more personally. You know, once you guys put it together and come up with a plan of what you really want to do with it, and come back before us and ask.
Okay.
We can do the same.
So there's a net improvement of the building and acceptable use.
If you've got an idea who, what kind of tenants you expect in the building itself, that would make a difference, because that's going to tell us to alleviate Paul's concern as to how much traffic we're going to have.
Okay. Right, ideally they'd like a landscape architect or something. That's what they were thinking. Something kind of goes on that, but it's a professional office and it's not a customer.
And honestly, you know, I'm not looking for somebody, I'm not looking for tenants that would come in to be traffic, because if I'm going to have my stuff in the back, I don't want people coming in and out all day long. My main concern is, you know, the space in the back, if it can be cleared and used for what I want to use it for, and then obviously there's noise, there's dust, all that kind of stuff. So those are kind of the big concerns that I just wanted to bring up.
Well, then you have a site plan, and then we have to take a look at the site plan, and we've got to make sure that the abutters are protected and we have the correct setbacks, and there's a lot, and screening, and there's a lot that goes into that. So
you may have to be involved with conservation too. I don't know how close the wetland is.
My dad is an engineer too, so I actually did do some of that. So we have access. He works with Webby. He's been an engineer a long time. So Richard De Benedictus.
Okay, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, so I've done work with him. So we're familiar with the wetlands. I've worked in that.
Can I ask one question?
Of course.
What you're proposing is not attached to the building up front, right?
It is separate. Yep.
Separate. I understand that. So you don't have control of the full site, is that correct?
Right. It's
you don't. Mm-hmm. So how does that occur?
So
what happens when somebody else buys the front building?
So if this was an allowable use with the planning board and with zoning, it's up for sale right now. So we would have some of those negotiations for exclusive use separations. And to do that, there is the two driveways. So the proposal I would think would make sense is to have one of the driveways be
Be under common ownership, right?
The common ownership as far as
the driveway.
No, you won't own two buildings.
So how do we get you frontage?
The frontage. So the frontage is a share as far as it's considered kind of a condo property, but he would own 1.22. This is just how it's set up right now. Mm-hmm. Is a 0.66 acres for the front building, and then the point, it's 1.22.
So he
the majority
would become
of the land.
The front building would become non-conforming as a result of this purchase?
There wouldn't be an official subdivide unless that was something that was agreeable, but
it
would be an exclusive use.
But they're two separate parcels today, with two separate owners?
They have two separate owners, but
the
land is
property.
Yes.
That's a condo. It's a
condo.
Right.
Condo.
Yeah, so it's a shared thing, so right now it's not
when you're driving.
Is there a condo association in place now to control these two buildings?
Not an association, there are condo documents.
We have reported each business has,
lawyer,
you know, 150 feet of frontage.
Yeah.
Frontage.
Right.
Without the building in front under your control, you have no frontage.
You've got a piece of landlocked land.
And you're going to get into a bigger legal problem than you can think of.
So there's not, it's not actually technically landlocked.
Talk to your dad.
Tell him
how concerned is.
That lacks frontage, first of all. Without control of the front building.
Okay.
I think you don't have frontage.
Go to Book 53.
Okay. I hope it's still available.
Yeah.
No, well, it's just, listen, I'm just bringing up, I was bringing up an option.
Yep.
Right. Mm-hmm. I'm just, that is a tough site.
Right.
No, I was just gonna say.
You know, maybe, it really is. Maybe it's in the ballpark of the purchase price because it has issues.
Sure.
Right. I mean, it will become something, but who knows what. You know? But you know, I'm not. You can always apply to put whatever you're going to put in there and reach agreement, and propose it and see what happens.
Sure. Right? Makes sense. Sure. Well, I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Have a good evening. Thank you. Take care.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Thanks. I used to go into Douglas because it's tough because it was a marketing place.
Yeah. I think they were food brokers.
Yeah, they still got the sign there. Are they still in business, those food brokers?
Yeah, they're still in business. I think
then I walked past it often.
They're trying to sell them both?
What are they doing now?
Nothing.
No.
I just wanted to come hang out with you guys.
Probably on the back door tonight. The condo association.
You guys are busy tonight, huh?
Not too bad.
How can you? You would think that when they were divvying up that as a condo, they would have thought of that.
They're
like basically
really awkward.
They have common driveway.
It's a mess.
No, but you don't know what a board thought of in the past because
that's a
well, that'd be a
old
board or just their attorney.
This is Pembroke.
That's an old. It's an old.
What
do you remember this? You must have been bored with this.
Sorry, what?
When they made this condo.
This combination? No.
You said aware, right?
I always thought it was under common ownership. I know no condo association. It used to be a restaurant years ago. Have you been in town?
This for a project?
You probably remember, no?
What? Oh, yeah, this is
a restaurant out back.
Conservation.
It's called Maison de Saint-Bron, and it's
Maison de
There was like dentists in there.
The dentist was
well, that was after what? They had a restaurant in there initially.
I'm learning. I'm listening.
So basically, the Form A that you guys endorsed before for him, there were like two minor errors in the drawing. So he and his neighbor decided to drop a new one. So he's actually done a new application for it. And it just came up. He just called me a few days ago, so I didn't have time to put on the agenda. But since it's virtually the identical. To the previous one.
What was the error?
The two spelling errors on her first name, which they wanted addressed. I know, but they don't want to spell them a shot, so they want their name spelled right. I got to go with the flow. So they just spelled her first name improperly. Also, I had a few fence posts that were slightly over the line here.
Yeah.
And once we decided we're going to go back and have anything messed with the plan again, I pulled them onto my land and had Grady's replot that. So. They're just, it's not even actually a fence, it's wooden posts with wire hooked to it. But now it is on our land, and the name is spelt properly. So I just need another signature, and it turned into a whole new reapplication. I never took the other one to...
Record it?
Never recorded it. So